to keep me guessing.
Hello, everybody. It's Christina here.
I'm Billy.
Amra, ti sei presa tutta la telecamera. Sì, non ci sono più io in primo piano. Ci sei tu. Hello everybody, it's Christina here. Welcome back to my channel. Or welcome in case you're new. I know it has been a while, haven't been active on YouTube ever since I think January was the last time I posted a video. I filmed a lot of videos, haven't posted any. I'm gonna explain why in another video, but this video, the one I'm filming right here, right now, it is all about TV shows. Because who doesn't love TV shows, right? Oh my god, my hair looks terrible. Anyways, last year, at around this same time of the year, I posted a video that was titled something like TV shows you should binge watch this summer. And on this cloudy, rainy, gloomy day in Sicily, which is rare, but it happens, sadly, I decided that it was time to film another TV shows you should binge watch this summer, or something like that. I don't remember the title. First TV show I have here is a TV show I've already talked about on my channel, and I'm gonna leave the link up here. It wasn't my thing, like October favorites or something like that, fall favorites, I don't remember. But the TV show I am hinting about is Okay, if you guys know me, you know I am obsessed with Rain. Rain is an historical TV show, has been cancelled after 3 seasons, I think. If I'm not wrong, it was on the CW, and it is absolutely gorgeous. Oh my god, I love that TV show. It is about Mary, Queen of Scots. And it is set in like medieval times. I think it was like 400, something like that. First 2 seasons are in France, and 3rd season is set in Scotland. It's not 100% historically accurate, but it is. I just love it. It's so cute. I adore it. And Adelaide Kane, who's the girl that plays Mary, she's an amazing actress. She's so great. I yeah, even if you're not into historical TV shows, you should watch it, because it's like very like romance based TV show, like not really historic. Like, yes, it's set in the past, so it is historical, but it's more romance than anything else, so you should watch it. The second one I have here is still sort of historical, but I'm not really sure if it's historical. It's still set in the past, but this one is set in the 20s, so it's a bit less old. And it's the first Netflix original show from Spain, and it is called Cable Girls in English, Las Chicas de Cable in Spanish, and I love it. I binge watched it. It was like, it's 2 seasons that came out, and I watched both of the seasons in like January or something in like 3 days, maybe 2.5. It is about these girls who work in they're cable girls, so you know, like when like you had to like call and like the. But it is about these girls who work as cable girls in a world that's basically controlled by men, and it's about them and like showing everyone else what they're capable of. And, like, there's a lot of like feminist struggle in there, and it is, there's a bit of mystery as well, a lot of romance, because gotta love gotta love romance. I mean, you need a little bit of romance in everything.
It's good.
It is a good TV show. It's definitely worth watching. And it's definitely a binge-worthy TV show. It's not one of those TV shows that you can, like, watch an episode and then go to another episode, like, after a few days. No, it's one you, like, watch an episode and then you can't just... You can't stop, right? You just have to keep watching it. Next show I have on my list, it's one that if you had told me before it came out that I was gonna put this on my binge-worthy TV shows list, I would have said, ha, no, not happening. I was very skeptical about this, and if you know me, you know I'm obsessed. I was, and I still am, obsessed with Scum. And, I mean, as someone who was so in love with the original season, when I heard they were gonna make, like, so many remakes in so many different countries, I was very skeptical about it. I have tried to watch all the remakes, and the only one of season one, because season two is a whole lot of story, the only one of season one I was able to stick to, and I really, really liked, and I really, really enjoyed, it was Come Italy. I know it sounds like I'm saying it just because I'm Italian, but honestly, I've read a lot of reviews, even like foreign people that were like, yes, Come Italy is the best, I love it. Honestly, it's the best remake ever. Scam Austin is not that bad, but it's just like season one of Scam is boring itself, and Scam Austin is even more boring than the original one, so ugh. But season one of Scam Italy is so good. It's not boring at all. They have changed a lot of things, like for example, Scam France was literally Scam Norway translated in French. Why do you do that? But Scam Italy is like, yes, the main storyline is that one, but they have changed a lot of things, and it does reflect the reality of Italian teenagers very, very well. I can see my teenage self in them, so that's what Scam is all about. It's all about like telling real life teenage stories. What I just said doesn't make any sense, but the fact that Scam Italy is so close to my teenage experience, my high school experience, it means they have done a great job. And also the stories, like, they kind of stir it up a little bit. It's not as boring as Scam Norway was. The director has shown all the boring Italian TV show directors how a TV show should actually be made, because, like, honestly, Italian directors are not really great with TV shows. I have to admit that. Actually, Italian TV shows are not really great. The acting in Scam Italy is not amazing, but what did you expect? It's Italian people, and they're like, it's teenagers, they're all young. So next show I have on this list, it's also one that if you had told me before I started it that I was gonna end up writing this, like putting this TV show on this list, I would have said nah. When I watched the trailer, I was like, this is so not my thing, like, but my flatmate actually wanted to watch it, so I was like, right, I'll watch episode one with you. We watched episode one and we were both so confused. She ended up not watching it. I continued watching it and I literally couldn't stop. I love it. I fell in love with it. What I'm talking about, it's Money Heist. That is the English title. The original Spanish title, because it's a Spanish TV show, it's Casa de Papel, which means paper house, which makes much more sense, because, like, the title in English, Money Heist, is so good. It's terrible. Spanish title is so much better, and it kind of like, if you think about it, it really reflects the show. So I'll go for the Spanish title, like, at least change the English title into Paper House, please. Please. Anyways, what is it about? Casa de Papel, it's about a group of thieves who decide to do an attack to the Royal Mint in Spain. I don't know if I said that right. But anyways, it's the place where they print money. It is amazing. The way they show how, like, they plan the whole attack and the attack itself and how the police reacts to it and everything, it's so great. And then it's done so well that it makes you wonder who is the good and who is the bad, not only in the show but like in real life. It makes you ask yourself questions and you just can't stop watching it. And yes, there is robots in it, which, I mean, if you know me, you know I love my robots. So next show I have on here is 100% my style. This is one I would have never doubted I would have watched and loved, and it is Dynasty, the remake, not the old one, because, like, I haven't actually found the old one online to watch it, and I actually don't think I'm gonna be able to get through the whole of, I don't know how many seasons they've done. So Dynasty is about this rich family that lives in Atlanta, Georgia, and they are rich, and it shows how they, like, fight between each other and, like, their problems, and, like, yeah, and it's literally Gossip Girl for older people. Wait, older people for older people. How could you not love it? Like, I mean, if you have watched and loved Gossip Girl, girl, boy, whatever, get on with it. Like, watch it right now. What are you doing still here? Like, get Netflix, watch it now, right now. On that note, I am gonna end this video because the camera already stopped filming 3 times, which is saying something. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a big old thumbs up if you did. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me, because I'm back. I'm stronger than I'm back stronger than ever, more motivated than I was before, and I'm gonna make a lot of videos this summer, also because I have nothing else to do. So, duh. And yeah, I'm doing some exciting things this summer as well. So, watch out for vlogs. And yeah, I love you guys very much. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again very, very soon.